Raven, Garnet,
Amethyst,
and Pearl,
and Steven!
Hello, friend. This is a tutorial showing you how to make your own Steven Universe-style logo. You'll need a few things to be able to follow this tutorial. Photoshop CS5 Extended or above, the Crystal Universe font by MaxiGamer, and some logo assets from my Mega folder. Links for the assets you'll need are in the description. I'll talk about the specific assets you need from the Mega when I'm using them. When you've downloaded the Crystal Universe font, open it and click the Install button. The regular ODF version will do. Open Photoshop and make a new document. The document will need to be quite large. The larger you make it, the higher quality your logo will look in the end. I'm going with around 4K resolution, that's 3840 by 2160. Create some text on your new document and use the Crystal Universe font I suggested at the start of the video. You want this text to fill most of the document, so you might need a very high number for the font size. Write in whatever you want your new title to be. I'm going with Logo Tutorial for the purposes of this video. If you're using the regular version of the font, you need to choose the faux italic option in the character options, and you should capitalize the first letter of each word. Capital letters in this font have the stars cut out of them, like in the U on the real logo. You'll need to space the lower line so the two capital letters line up correctly, as if they're joined up. And finally, you may need to change the line spacing, that's the leading property of the text, to space the two lines the way you want. I forgot to do it at this point, but to put a star in your text, like in the real logo, use the asterisk key. Now you have your title looking good, we're going to create a 3D extrusion of the text. Right-click on your text layer and choose New 3D Extrusion from selected layer. Now your text is 3D, you need to set the right general settings. Firstly, click on the 3D element named after the text you've written, so mine is called Logo Tutorial here, and look at its properties. You want to disable cast and catch shadows, and set the extrusion depth to about 700 pixels. Then, you should go to the current view, and set the camera mode to orthographic projection. This will keep the text looking flat while you angle the 3D extrusion correctly. So next, we want to angle the text to get it looking right. Select the element named after your text again, and choose this button to go to the object's angle and position options. I played around with the angle for a while, and I ended up with the following settings. The X angle is 7 degrees, Y angle minus 9 degrees, and 0 in the Z. At this point, you should import one of the text extrusion colors images from the Mega folder and place it somewhere out of the way in your document. I've got it at the top left here. These are reference colors, accurate to the original logo. Select the extrusion material 3D element and set the color of the diffuse texture to the red color from the color sample. I strongly advise you start with Text Extrusion Colors version 2. You'll be able to change it later if you want. We need to set up the lighting now. By default, there should be one infinite light placed when you made a 3D object. Select it and go to its angle options. For this first light, we want to light up the bottom left of the text with the white light, making it appear red. If you follow the previous settings well, then the following angles will work. X angle minus 25 degrees, Y angle minus 30 degrees, and Z angle minus 42 degrees. Make a second infinite light, you'll find the button down here. Set its color to the second color from the color sample, and set its angle to match the following. X angle minus 35 degrees, Y angle 75 degrees, and Z angle minus 75 degrees. It may not have a very strong effect, so increase the light's intensity until it looks similar to what I've got here. I ended up using about 260% intensity. Now you should have a 3D logo that looks similar to the real thing, albeit with smooth shading instead of the two-color cel-shaded look from the real logo. We'll address that difference shortly. What you want to do now is set the diffuse texture color of the front of your text, listed as the front inflation 3D element, to something completely different to the background colors. I suggest bright green. Right-click on the layer that contains your 3D object and duplicate it. Then, right-click on the duplicate and choose Rasterize 3D. This new layer is now just 2D pixels. Hide everything else so it's the only thing visible, and open the Save for Web dialog. Set the file type to PNG8 and turn off dithering here. We need to clear the color table, so click this little menu button here and choose Select All Colors. Now hold Control on your keyboard and click the transparent color to deselect it, then use this little delete button. What we need to do now is add the two colors from the color sample you're using to the color table. Switch to the original view at the top left here and use the eyedropper to select each color and add it to the color table. Now switch back to the optimized view and you should see a nice two color background. Save the result. The final thing you want to do with your 3D object is to get a PNG of the front face of the text. Use the magic wand tool to select all of the letters of your text. Choose Layer, New, Layer via Copy. Now make sure this is the only visible layer and save it to another PNG. No need for any special color settings for this one. Before we move on to the next part, I want to point out that now you have the 3D scene set up, it should be easy for you to change it to display different titles. If you go back to the 3D editor and select the 3D object element, you can find this Edit Source button. Using this, you're able to change the text which generated the 3D object, meaning new titles can be generated very easy from the same document template. Okay, we're almost done. Create a new Photoshop document, the same size as we started out with, and import the PNGs of your low-color text extrusion and your logo's face text. Make sure they're lined up correctly. Now, import whichever logo text background you need from my mega folder. Place it over the top of your font face. Right-click on the layer and select Create Clipping Mask. Almost perfect. The final touch is to add the outline around the logo, but for that, it all needs to be merged down to a flat image. You can either merge the layers or export your document to PNG if you want to save this document and keep it separate layers. Once you have your merged image, right-click on its layer and select Blending Options. Select Stroke, copy the color from the red of the extruded text, make sure the stroke is outside with normal blending, and select the size until it looks right by eye. I use 20 pixels at this resolution. There we have it. If you did all this at a high enough resolution, you should be able to scale it down to the required resolution and get something that looks good. If the logo we've made so far is all you need, then you're done. But I'm going to talk about a few other things you might want to do with it from here. One thing you might want to do is convert your logo to another color scheme. There have been two official ones so far, with the first and second versions of the opening song showing slightly different logos, as you can see here. This is very easy to do if you followed this tutorial closely. Go back to your document with your incomplete, layered logo and hide everything but the extruded text. Have the two colors you want to replace available. I have Text Extrusion Colors version 1 at the top left here. Start by using the Magic Wand tool to select one of the red areas. Now go to Select, Similar, and all of the red areas should be selected. Use the eyedropper to select the color you're replacing it with, and go to Edit, Fill. Make sure Foreground Color is selected here, and click OK. Now you just need to do the same for the other color, pink here. Now that you've updated the extrusion colors, you just need to replace the text background image and add the stroke outline, as I showed before. If you want to put your logo on an image or video version of the opening sequence, I suggest you start off by positioning it in Photoshop. That'll give us a chance to add in a credit, like in the real title as well. Download one of the cleared logo still images from my mega folder and open it in Photoshop. Import your finished logo and place it over the top. Remember to hold shift while you resize it so it doesn't get distorted. Rotate it a bit to match the original logo. Add the two sets of credit colors from the mega folder to your document as a reference. To recreate the credit from the original title, created by Rebecca Sugar, add some text under your logo. Use the Crystal Universe font again, but just stick to lowercase. At this size, I used 24-point text for the created by part, and 40-point text for the name. The name should be a separate text layer. Use the credit color image's left colors for the text colors. When your text is set up, right-click on a text layer and choose blending options. Add a drop shadow, take its color from the relevant color sample, and set it to 150 degrees with a distance of 8. Do the same for the second text layer. Now the text looks right, place the layers next to each other. Then select both text layers and go to Edit, Transform, Rotate. Rotate and position the text so it follows the bottom of the text, as in the real logo, and you should be finished. If you're happy with a still image, you can just save what you've done here to a PNG or JPEG and use it how you'd like. If you want to add it to a video though, hide everything but your logo and credit text and save that as a transparent PNG. Download whichever cleared intro video you need from my mega folder. Add it and your logo to your video editor of choice. I'm using Sony Vegas here. Place the video on your timeline, followed by the logo PNG at the point when it's needed. Simple. All you need to do from here is render the video. You can see the full results of this at the very start of this video. Thank you very much for sticking with me for this very long video. I hope it's been helpful for you. Remember to press all the positive YouTube buttons. Here's a picture of me and my guinea pig. She is a good girl. Goodbye.